Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Dr. Boyce Watkins. Welcome to the Black Financial Channel, where we talk about financial issues, particularly of interest to the black community. But this story is not about a black person. This is actually a story about a young lady in South Korea. Her last name is Borum, or I guess Borum is the name that she just performs with on YouTube. Well, anyway, Borum. She's 6 years old. She's on YouTube, and she has about 30 million subscribers on YouTube. And she got a lot of attention recently because she just bought this big house. Apparently, she bought an $8 million house. They said that she has $30 million subscribers on YouTube, which is massive. And according to a public real estate registration document, the transaction was made through the Borum family company set up by the girl's parents. So the family has a company that came, I guess, apparently from her being a YouTube star. She has two channels. One has 13.6 million subscribers, and another one is a video blog that has 17.6 million subscribers. Her most popular videos can attract 300 million views, and in one clip, her most watched video, which has 376 million views, she and her friends make some black instant noodles in her pink and purple plastic toy kitchen, and then she eats them. This is fascinating because it really shows you how much money people are making on YouTube. And YouTube is awesome. It's like a television network. And I can tell you that if you have a special skill or talent, having a YouTube channel is good, not just for the ad revenue, which can be significant depending on what kind of channel you have, but also because it allows you an opportunity to practice if you're a public speaker or want to build your brand eventually as a radio show host or TV host or as a teacher. Also, it's a great way to promote, talk about other products that you may have, things like that. Like, so when I write a book, I'll talk about it a lot on YouTube. In fact, if you have a good YouTube following, you actually can do, you can reach your audience more effectively through YouTube a lot of times than you can by going on TV or radio and stuff like that. So the internet's really opened up the game as far as media communications. Also, a lot of you have cute kids. A lot of you have kids that sit around and watch videos like this all day long. I know we got a 9-year-old who just walks around and she's got the screen to her face. And we're like, put that screen away, stop that, but she does a lot of watching of these videos that are out there, and it doesn't make any sense, but those eyeballs generate revenue. And so it's changing a lot of corporate strategy in terms of how companies advertise products. Like, this little girl's probably making a ton of money from companies reaching out to her family and saying, hey, can you review our toy? Can you review our toy? Now, her work isn't without controversy. An organization called Save the Children took a big issue with some of the values being promoted in her video. I think she showed a bit, there was video of her stealing money from her father's wallet, things like that. And I think that's actually quite good that you have people that are sort of monitoring what messages are being sent to kids, because in the black community we don't do enough of that. We have people promoting hip-hop where little, 10-year-olds are rapping about having sex and killing each other and stealing from each other and everything else. And then you look at what's going on in our community, it's not disconnected. Media plays a role in shaping people's values. It's been known for thousands of years, whatever the media happened to be. And so I encourage you to just kind of be mindful of that, in terms of what kind of media you are okay with in your family, but also be mindful of the fact that YouTube is a great business opportunity. There's a lot of stuff going on in YouTube that literally multi-million dollar transactions. So whenever you see a channel that has a million subscribers or something like that, just know that that person's probably making a ton of money from that channel. And so maybe it's something that you may want to do yourself. It's a great way. It's a great. I think it's a perfect supplement to your business, whatever business you're in. I would look into getting a YouTube channel. So anyway, please hit the thumbs up button, hit the share button, hit the subscribe button, and also if you're watching this video before August 3rd, we're doing Emancipation Weekend in the Black Business School. It's a free event. If you want to learn how to buy multifamily properties and get into the real estate game as an investor, Julian Gordon, who's a Stanford University graduate, our Dean of Real Estate in the Black Business School, is actually going to do a free event. So you can sign up at theemancipationequation.com, THE, that's the emancipationequation.com. Also, if you want to build a business school in your house, teach your kids about business, we have a small packet that doesn't cost a lot of money, but it has lots of great tools in it, financial workbooks and flashcards and things like that. You can go to financialworkbooks.com. That's financialworkbooks.com. So please take care. Have a great day. I'm Dr. Boyce Watkins. Make sure you subscribe. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Peace.